Hey everybody, this is day 7 of my fast, and I just want to thank everyone who's prayed for me, sent me good energy, and when I logged in this morning, I had a lot of comments and personal messages, and I promise you I'm going to write each and every one of you back, and I just want to really say thank you. It's an absolute miracle that I've made it this far. So, thank you, everybody. And I have a little bit of bad news, for me at least. On Saturday morning, my scale's battery, I hope it's the battery, I hope the scale's not broken. My scale's battery decided to stop working. So I kind of knew that it was like getting low, because I was getting like some whacked out readings the last like couple days. Like it would say one thing, but then it would go all crazy on me. But I didn't think it would happen this fast. So normally I would have ran out and got another battery, because I have to weigh myself every day. But my fiance and I, our budget's just a little bit tight right now because he just started a new job. He actually just moved here from LA. So he just started a new job and we're not getting his first paycheck till the end of the month. So the money I do have is like for food and gas, and I don't get paid until the 25th. So, like, on that day, I will be, like, running to get a battery. So, if need be, if the anxiety gets to me too bad, I will, like, go to a friend's house and weigh myself if I have to. So, that might happen. I guess if you don't have an eating disorder or you have never tried to lose weight, or even if you've never fasted, your scale breaking is probably no big deal. People's scales break every day. And they're like, oh, I have to get a battery, and, you know, they replace it when they want to, but I have tried to go without, like, weighing myself. I used to weigh myself all day, every day, so it's good that now it's just in the morning, but, I can't do it. I cannot do it, and, like, even, ever since the battery's broke. I touch it every morning to see if it'll go on. I've shook it. I took the battery out. So, yeah, that's causing me some anxiety. But I do feel lighter, and I know logically that I've lost weight, and I feel like I'm starting to see it a little bit. I'm hoping by Friday it's real noticeable, and I'm hoping by October 20th it's super noticeable. So, that was a downer. Otherwise, I'm feeling pretty good. I feel like this fast, really, I really could do the whole 60 days because of all the support I'm getting, and I feel like I'm doing the right thing. People seem to be interested in watching me fast, and so for that reason alone, I really want to keep going. So, I feel good about the fast, and it's bringing some things up for me that, frankly, when I'm eating and stuffing myself with food and not feeling, I don't deal with. And the truth is, like, all this stuff about my sexual abuse, my feelings about it, I haven't talked about that stuff for, like, a year. And so just that alone, like, bringing those issues up for myself and dealing with them and, you know, realizing how they're affecting my life in prayer and trying to forgive and all this kind of stuff, I think it's good. It's good for the fast. It's good for me. It's good for other people. So I'm going to keep on fasting. Some good news is my daughter won. She was nominated for homecoming court in her sophomore class, and she won. So in our school system, you can't win homecoming queen unless you're senior, but she's a sophomore and she won for her class, so that was really cool. On Saturday, I helped her get dressed and she looks so pretty, and I think today or tomorrow I'm going to put some of her pictures up on my MySpace. I'm going to put a movie up of all the pictures. So she's the girl in the orange dress, if you're interested, and probably today or tomorrow that'll be up. So some people have asked me what my daughter looks like. So if you just go to my MySpace link on my YouTube page, you'll be able to see. So, she's so pretty. Oh, God. Okay. And some other interesting news was I really missed recording my YouTube videos, just because I'm realizing it's giving me a good outlet to kind of think out loud as I'm fasting things that are coming up for me. And the support that I'm getting, I really need it. I feel so isolated with my eating disorder that my friends, my family, they don't get it. So knowing that there's a lot of women like all over the world who understand what I'm saying and we can connect here on YouTube is making a difference in my fast. So I made the decision to tell my fiance that I've been recording videos on YouTube, recording my fast, talking about my eating problems and my sexual abuse. And the reason I did that was because it's easy to record videos around my daughter because she's so busy. She's always doing something. So, like, she's basically hardly here. But my fiance's always here on the weekends all the time. So for me to be able to record a YouTube video, he had to be in the know about what I was doing. So surprisingly, he was supportive. He was like, if this is what it's going to take for you to work through your issues and stick to this fast, because last year I did a long fast, but this year I've attempted to do several long fasts and I keep failing. So he's like, if this is what it's going to take for you to stick to the 60-day fast, because ever since he's met me, I've talked about this miracle 60-day fast I was going to do. He's like, if this is what it's going to take for you to stick to your fast, then I want you to do it. So from what I can see, God himself wants me to fast. And the reason I say that is I've got my fiance support. Everything I'm hearing on YouTube is supporting it, and it's happening. I mean, I'm doing it, day 7. So I feel like I'm supposed to fast, and at the end of this fast, besides just losing weight, I'm going to achieve some things emotionally and in my heart that I've been needing to do probably all my life. And I'm excited to share it with other people and maybe inspire other people to do a fast, even if it's only a short fast, because I think when you're fasting, the clarity that you get, it's like nothing else. You can't describe it. It's something you have to experience. I can tell you my experience, and hopefully my experience will inspire you, but you cannot know or understand what I'm saying unless you yourself are fasting, even if you only do it for 3 days. So I feel really confident that I'm doing the right thing and that it's good. So before I logged on, I saw Sophie Girls. I believe it's her latest video, but she said she's fasting today, October 16th. I just want to say yay! I know you can do it. And the good news is, you know, you're working, so you can stay busy during the day even though you're around food, but it's a little easier to not want to eat when you're working all day. The toughest part is going to be dinner time. I mean, what I do is I cook the meals, put it on the table, and then I go in my room and watch TV until they're done. I make my fiance, you know, clean up after himself. Well, he does it on his own, but I'm just saying he cleans up after himself, and that's the way to do it. And the other thing, which I keep forgetting, is to get some ice and put it in a blender and chop it up really fine. And that's good to, like, spoon out of a cup and eat it and, like, crunch on it. Just the ice gets that crunchy feeling out. But you get a brain freeze. Your mouth, my jaw at least, gets, like, cold fast. But, you know, it helps, like, get that urge to crunch on something out. So try that. If you have a Sonic by you, their bags of ice are, like, $1.50, and they have the best ice to crunch on. So anyways, that's just a little tip, but I hope you do it, Sophie girl. I'm really proud of you. And I haven't seen barely anyone else's comments or my inbox, but I'm going to get back to everyone. Just please keep praying for me. I know I'm doing the right thing, and I know sharing my experience is the right thing. It's important for people to know what happens to you when you fast. And from what I know, no one's done a 60-day fast on YouTube before. I found someone who did a 37-day, but not a 60-day. So I'm excited to see what happens at the end of these 60 days. So I just want to wish everyone a really good day, and I'm okay, and it's because of you guys that I'm fasting. So please keep tuning in and stay in contact with me, because I really appreciate it. And feel free to ask me any questions, and I'll answer them in my next video. Okay, thanks. Bye.